Welcome to Chemistry with Caroline. In this video, we're going to look at the alkylation of aromatics using alkenes and alcohols as the starting materials for the electrophiles that are generated. So if we put an alkene in the presence of acid, we can protonate it and make an electrophile for the benzene ring to attack. So the pi electrons are going to be attracted to the proton. And only the most stable carbocation will form. So the H that I've added has gone onto the one carbon, that's the exterior carbon, the primary one, and the carbocation ends up on the secondary position. And this is my electrophile for my electrophilic aromatic substitution reaction. With the generation of the carbocation intermediate, the electrophile for the reaction has been made. So the benzene ring will attack. This is the slow step because this step disrupts the aromaticity of the aromatic ring. And so I'm putting an isopropyl group on here. Then I get a positive charge adjacent to it. The double bond spans two carbons, so the group will go on one and the other will be positive. That charge can get shared around the benzene ring. So these are all the resonance contributors to this intermediate. The positive charge circulating around the benzene ring is called an arenium ion. So there'd be one more contributor with the positive charge there. So these are the Lewis structures for the resonance contributors for the arenium ion. And then, in order to restore aromaticity, I'm going to redraw the structure over here so we have plenty of room. So you can really use any of those structures, but I'll just draw this one. It's probably easiest to see when the charge is adjacent to the group with the H that's going to be pulled off, which is that only sp3 hybridized carbon in the ring, the one that the electrophile has been introduced to. And so I'm in sulfuric acid, that's an aqueous acid, and the strongest base I have in solution is water. So that water molecule is going to grab the proton, these electrons are going to fold over, and that is going to restore aromaticity to the compound. This is my fast step because of that, restoring the stability of this compound. And now the alkyl group has been generated, and then you have H3O plus generated, you're already in acidic solution, that proton can go on to protonate another alkene, generate another electrophile, and the reaction can continue on. In a similar manner to the alkene, we could protonate an alcohol, get that to leave, and then that will generate a carbocation electrophile. So really, in these alkylation reactions, you're just generating a carbocation by making a good leaving group or protonating an alkene, and then the benzene ring will attack it, and you've added an alkyl substituent in that manner. So with respect to an alcohol, if we protonate OH, which is a poor leaving group, we can make a good leaving group in water. And so here, my water molecule has been generated. That makes for a good leaving group. And so now the water molecule can leave. And again, that would generate a carbocation, and that carbocation would be the electrophile. So the benzene ring could come to attack this carbocation, and then ultimately you end up with that alkyl group attached. And that would be this product right here. The mechanism that it proceeds through would be identical to the one that we've just seen in terms of the creation of the arenium ion and then deprotonation by water to restore aromaticity. So this has been a look at some additional ways to add an alkyl group to an aromatic compound. The Friedel-Crafts alkylation is a very well-known way. There's a separate video on that. But any way that I can generate a carbocation can create an electrophile that a benzene ring can attack. If you found this video helpful, please like, subscribe, and share with your friends. Thanks.